The captor's signature move in the film is a creature that comes out of his hand. We talked about creating the scorpion effect with a physical model that you could see and that the actors could interact with. This might have been easier in the shooting process, but ultimately, this would have limited us to a simpler look and movement style. With the digital creature, our bounds were limitless.
This is a model that we proposed for the scorpion creature, the actual projectile that flies through the air. You can see here that it's just made of a kind of a gray plastic, but when it's represented in the computer, we're going to give it a kind of a real lethal-looking gunmetal kind of a look to it. These blue lines are the actor's hand as stored in the computer. The white lines are the scorpion. That's the way the computer sees the scorpion. Now, what we do is we take it from these lines into a kind of a shaded format, and this is the first step in that process. When you're doing animation, one of the things that you really want to do is you want to bring something to life. You want to give it a personality. In this particular instance, we wanted to give it more than a personality. We wanted to give it an attitude.
What we did to create Shang Tsung's island, which of course was not originally an island, it's a peninsula with very rounded peaks that we made look scarier and more ominous by extending with a digital matte painting. There were, of course, unfortunately, boats when we were shooting that day, so we got rid of the boats. We put our own dragon's wing ship in so you can see where the actors are coming from and created an island that didn't even exist.
When we model it in the computer, it ends up looking something like this. This is a wireframe representation of the creature. And what we can do is use computer software to move it around. It doesn't actually exist except in the computer, but we can make it move in any way that we want to, and the image of that creature will appear on the movie screen when we're finished.